Hey yo, what is up y'all? It's your boy Eric and I'm back with another video. So I was supposed to go get a haircut and I actually went to the barbershop, hence the intro. I was supposed to come back with a haircut, you know, looking all clean and stuff, but man, I can't wait at the barbershop for more than one haircut. I'm cool with waiting if someone's already getting cut and like they're like halfway through, but if there's someone after that before me, I'm leaving. So I left. Since we're on the topic of haircuts, I wanted to start this video off with kind of a story time of how my high school made me cut my hair in 10th grade. So basically, I had just got a perm that summer. So I was straight feeling myself. It was like the third day of school and I got called to the office, but it was like a conference room. It wasn't the main office because there was like 10 or 15 other kids with me. And we all got called down for uniform infractions. Let me give you guys a little detail about my school. So my school was a charter school, very, very conservative. We had crazy rules and uniform. So that just sets this into more perspective for you guys, because I know at a public school, this would never fly. So yeah, I got called to the office and the reason was because our hair had a volume of more than 2 inches. Like, they tried to say that you can't have hairstyles where your hair extends out of your head for more than 2 inches, which makes no sense at all. Fast forward a couple months, I came in with a man bun because my hair had grown out and I put it back and I got a haircut, like a man bun haircut. You guys know what that is. But they said that I needed to cut it because shave sides. Ultimately, I had to do what I had to do, so I had to cut it. If I didn't, it was a uniform infraction, and after you get 2, it's a 1-hour detention. And my mom wasn't the type of... My mom is Chinese. She's not the type of mom to go into the school and start yelling at the principal because, you know, blah, 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 this isn't fair. My kid needs to express himself, yada, yada, yada. She was like, nah, just follow the rules, you know, stay out the way and don't get in trouble. One thing about my school is that you can't really express yourself through clothing, through anything physical. The way I felt was that was like taken away from me. And that kind of goes into my philosophy for hair slash haircuts, which basically is do it before you get old. Think about this. When you get older, most likely, you're not gonna wanna do the hairstyles that you're doing now, such as like dyeing your hair, getting crispy haircuts. Like, most likely, you're gonna have a generic old person haircut. And that was my philosophy for a lot of my hairstyles because, I mean, I was basically just expressing myself, but I didn't know that because I didn't know that people express themselves through like hair and like other physical aspects because my school never let me. But fast forward 1 year later, they started cracking down on extensions, like braids, which was crazy. At this point, they got too far out of hand and we ended up on national news.
Clock students punished, told that they can't go to prom, and it's all because of their hair extension.
Despite racking up 16 hours of detention at her school.
And honestly, the main takeaway from this experience is that, well, it was like one of those, if it doesn't kill you, it'll make you stronger type things, which kind of sucks, but honestly, that's how life is. It's something bad that I had to learn from and that I had to live through, so that's just how it was. It motivated me to be more creative and expressive in a way, and my school got put on blast. So that's all I could really ask for, even though it wasn't really my story specifically. And to this day, my school still never said sorry. The bald principal, I'm gonna put a picture of this dude. This dude is straight bald. This is the dude that was making all the rules. But yeah, that's just messed up to make a kid cut their hair. Like, it really is. So yeah, that's a pretty crazy story that I don't think anyone's really heard of, even if you have heard of the extension story. That was kind of the precursor to that story. They were trying to step things up until they got too crazy. Okay, let me get more into what I'm gonna be doing today because this video is ultimately going to be a vlog, and I'm going to go into Boston, get some work done, and then I'm going to either play some basketball and then go to my boy's dorm at BU. So I'll give you guys a little dorm tour of the brownstones at BU. But the basketball is contingent upon the win, honestly. Every time I end up filming, it's just not like the sunniest day, which I'm all right with. And I still feel like there's potential for the sun to come out, but yeah, I'm gonna be going to Boston. Enjoy the show. All right, so I'm gonna be going to the northeastern part of Boston today. The vibes today are pretty great. It's really warm outside today. And like I said before, the sun is coming out and I'm feeling it. But it's still a little windy, so I ended up texting my friend that we probably shouldn't play basketball and just hold on for another day. And ultimately, just chill at his dorm. So with no further ado, let me get to the train station, hop on the train, and get to a cafe, or I think I'm gonna go to Panera Bread, honestly. So I just got off the train and now I'm gonna walk like 5 minutes ish to this Panera Bread, which I'm gonna be able to sit down at and get some work done. But yeah, this is one of my favorite parts of Boston, honestly. The view of Boston is actually really cool. So yeah, I'm gonna catch y'all over there. That guy was spamming But like 5 minutes later, I'm at Panera Bread right now. I'm about to go inside. That's okay. Let our bodies, let our bodies do what they may, what they may. We don't gotta talk about it, babe. Alright, so let me get this a little closer so you guys can hear me better. So this whole time I've been trying to connect to the Wi-Fi, and it wasn't that I couldn't connect, it was that the Wi-Fi was just so bad that I couldn't tell if I was connected or not. I kind of mentioned this in my last video, but the way my college is working right now, my online experience, is that there isn't any sessions that are live. I haven't really pulled up to a live session since the first day of school. I know that sounds bad to say, but I've been watching all my lectures online, which are pre-recorded, and I figured I might as well kind of get into an update of how my online college experience is going while I wait for this video to load, because it keeps buffering. So yeah, in my last video, I kind of mentioned I was taking 3 business classes and then 1 class for my study abroad. And these 3 business classes are going pretty well right now. I just had my first exam for all 3 of them. I kind of noticed the pros and cons of this online college thing, and I want to say that I'm someone that doesn't really mind, and I kind of want to explain why. But first, before I even do that, I want to say that college is supposed to be in person, because I want to say 75% of the reason why I went to college is for the experience. It's the experience of first living on your own for the first time, most likely. Second, interacting with a bunch of kids that are your age, interacting with professors, creating connections, and creating friendships, ultimately. And 3, food. Okay, that wasn't one of the main reasons why I went to college, but it turns out that food is just important in my life. It's probably important in you guys' life too. But yeah, college is supposed to be in person so we can kind of experience all these things. But the one thing with online college that I really don't mind is that, for me personally, in some ways it's easier, but the fact that it's easier kind of takes away from, I guess, the fun of school. So let me explain that a little bit. So basically for my exams, there isn't like a proctor, and it's on the internet, obviously, so you can click anywhere you want. You're not supposed to, but you can, in a way that kind of made school a little boring, because for all my exams, I knew that I could have just, you know, went on check. Not saying I did, because I didn't. But yeah, that kind of took away from, you know, putting in the full effort to take these exams, because an exam in college is pretty freaking stressful. You get a bubble sheet, take it in person, and that's it. There's no other resources other than what you have and what you've learned and what you studied beforehand. So taking it online, bro, we already know that the internet is endless and the information on here is endless. Like, most of us have probably found the exam on Quizlet at one point in our lives. So that's one part of online college that to some people is amazing and great, and to some people kind of sucks. But I want to say that you kind of have to make do with what you have, and that's just one thing I noticed, honestly. So I want to say that it's a pro and a con, but yeah, in some ways it's helping my GPA, which is good, and I get to be at home, which is actually really nice, because I remember the one part about being away from home for the first time in my life, basically, is that when I came back, it just felt so good. That was one of the first things that I kind of experienced when going to college for the first time, and that goes back to what I was saying, college is all about the experience. So one tip for when we go back to college is to experience it. Get out of your comfort zone, talk to new people, have fun. And my lecture is probably somewhat loaded now, so I'm gonna get back to that.
Yeah, I'm making a change today. The liquor been taking the pain away. I heard you was giving your chain away. That's kind of like giving your fame away. What's wrong with you? I sit in a box where the owners do. A boss is a role that I've grown into. I love you to death, but I told you the truth.
The whole time I was talking, my video only loaded 5 minutes. I don't know how Wi-Fi could be so bad. So I'm gonna do what any logical person in Panera would do. Eat the best hospital food in America.
Are you recording?
Oh, I thought you might be. No, you can't record it here. Say what's up.
Ta-da!
Yo, I got 25 subscribers on YouTube right now. How do I get more?
You gotta do something more interesting.
I gotta do something more interesting? Tell me what I'm supposed to do. I only got 25.
I'm from the last generation. I just know you can find everything on YouTube.
Oh, guess what? More. I'm about to make you famous. What's your name?
Eric.
Eric what?
Eric He. E-R-I-C-H-E.
Subscribe to Eric He.
Word.
All right? Go to it.
Y'all heard her.
Yeah, I got one, Virgil got one, and that day is the only two, man. How many times have I shown and proved, man? How many nights I've been, whoa, swerving the potholes, not trying to fuck up the wheels on them.
Hold on, Eric He.
Enjoy your food. Eat the best one.
Road, okay. Funny how life goes. He thought he was sick, now we wiping his nose, okay. Soon as you give him your soul, you blow up, and they say you're selling your soul, okay. They want my life exposed. They want to know about the highs and lows. Well, summer all I did was rest, okay? And New Year's all I did was stretch, okay? And Valentine's Day I had sex, okay? We'll see what's about to happen next, okay? Okay, okay.
All right, so it's exactly 2:40 right now, and I'm about to head to the park and get some hoops out with my boy. Hold up. We actually were supposed to meet up at like 1:30, but yeah, things happen, so we're gonna end up playing some basketball, get some food, and I have to head out of here out of Boston at around 4:30 probably, because I didn't mention this before, but I have a I have a basketball game later, so I gotta get there at around 6. I'm gonna get wrapped up over here and meet my boy at the park. All right, it's clearly really windy out here, but the park was pretty active, I ain't even gonna lie. People out here.
Whoa, whoa, yeah, yeah, yeah. Look at your rollie, look at my rollie, that's a smart face, this a big face, she can't see my room, fuck her in the hallway. Getting bored with this money, count it all day. Yeah, they thought we were soft, boy, you learned the hard way.
Not with all the talking, turned it to a closed case. Look, pull a Scadella and a vanilla. All white, that plain Jane, yeah. The road's going better, running the better. I took the money and flooded my best. You diamond the rock, computer to set it.
All right, yo, you want to give us on a tour?
All right. Here's the location now. What's going on, everyone? So, honestly, the apartment's not really anything too crazy. I just did laundry, so it's a little so messy official, right now. So honestly, official. I wasn't really expecting a room tour, so, you know, apartment's kind of messy right now. Yeah, this is my room. You know, you got a little desk here. I keep my masks and shit in here. This is my school supplies.
All right, too detailed. Hurry it up.
Here we got the kitchen.
Also one of my favorite parts of this dorm, because it's like, you don't get a kitchen unless you live in a suite. And this is a double.
Exactly. Yeah, no, now that I have a kitchen, like, I don't know if everyone likes to cook. A lot of people don't like to cook, but me personally, I like to cook a lot. So now that I have a kitchen, like, I can never go back to not having one.
This is the view. Super nice. I ain't even gonna lie. It's a doubles technically, so this is where someone would live, but your roommate moved out, right?
Yeah, so this is South Campus. So like we don't even have a door. So like when my roommate was here, he put up like some kind of like a blanket. He just nailed it. This was his closet. He left the toilet paper. Paper towels for me to use.
Well, yeah, but the one thing I don't like about this is that you have to walk through your roommate's part to get to the bathroom.
So basically, if you're gonna get an apartment like this, be tight with whoever you room with.
Oh yeah,
that's the bathroom right there. It's a pretty small bathroom, to be honest. But I mean, it's a private bathroom. You can't complain.
All right, man. Tell the kids I want to go to BU. Give them some tips. Tell them anything you want. BU kids.
Alright, so I'm a junior at BU right now. I'm majoring in health science. I'm on a PT track. But you know, it's kind of hard.
Would you rather live in the towers or in a brownstone, since you live in both?
I definitely would rather live in a brownstone. So if you're gonna live in, like on-campus dormitories, I would live in West. That's where I lived my first 2 years, my freshman year and my sophomore year.
Yeah, that place is smooth.
I lived in West. West campus is nice. Plus it's next to the Fit Rec. So if you go to the gym a lot, it's really convenient.
Facts. So did you step on the seal?
Nah. That's the one thing you don't do. If you go on one of the campus tours, they'll tell you that. Like, it's like a superstition to not step on the seal. The thing is, they say like if you step on the seal, you're not gonna graduate. So I haven't stepped on it yet.
It's like, what time is it? 4:26, so we gotta head out of here, and I'll see y'all at home or at the train station.
All right, man. Take it easy.
Peace. All right, so I'm gonna head to the train station now. I'm not in a crazy rush, but since I'm taking the green line, I'm gonna have to take that all the way to downtown, which connects to the orange line, and then I'm gonna have to get on the orange line and then get back to Malden. And just that in itself takes so long, because if you're not from Boston, one thing I can say is that the green line is the worst line, and that's something everyone from Boston knows. That shit is slow as hell. So just give yourself time if you have to take the green line. Too many M's to make too many rules to break. Too many fighting that case. I gotta find my way. Gotta need new shoes. If I lose, she lose. And I ain't get used to losses. I'm going off till I crash. Fuck all the ops, I kid you not, see we gon' crash. My thoughts is sick, I don't have no sense. Sometimes I crash. Pour up this 1942 and knock me on my. It knocked me on my. Nigga gotta hit the golf course to get a piece. Hey, I'm about to get crazy. Damn, I don't wanna fall though. Fuck it. Nah, I ain't doing it.
I would have recorded.
I gotta do it now.
Oh, we out here!
Sometimes you gotta just do it because you know that you might not be able to do it. So you just gotta do it, you feel me? Hey, have a great day, guys. Hey, that's perfect timing right here.
All right, man. It's like 6:20 right now. I just got to the court. But the one thing that I want to say about this rec league is that honestly, it just feels like a blessing to be able to play ball, because I think for a whole year I didn't step on an indoor court because of COVID and whatnot. So from not being able to play at all to playing 5-on-5 with refs and stuff, that's really just a blessing. So yeah, I'm pretty grateful to have this opportunity. Nah, don't tell me, bro. Don't tell me we don't have a game today. Bro, it's mad late. It's like 6:25 right now. What's good, Breezy? So, let me see a three-pointer real quick. Splash team with the Gucci slides on.
I know that.
Hey! Hey.
Valentino's make you see him, you ain't gotta ask that.
This guy Eric, man, he's a bucket.
She with me, she a freak, you ain't gotta ask that. It ain't cheap, but I could lead you right to where the gas at. Double cup, mocha blunt, I ain't tryna pass that. Valentino's make you see him, you ain't gotta ask that. She with me, she a freak, you ain't gotta ask that. It ain't cheap, but I could lead you right to where the gas at. Double cup, mocha blunt, I ain't tryna pass that. Nah, I can show you where the stash at.
Alright, y'all, so we just got home, and to be honest, we lost, but it's all good, because we're going to play them again in the next upcoming weeks, and I'm pretty confident that we can beat them, so we'll see them then. But I want to say thank you so much if you made it to this part of the video. It really means a lot, because, shit, your boy only got 25 subscribers, so please consider subscribing. I just wanted to say that today was a pretty good day. The weather was pretty perfect. And yeah, overall good vibes. I did a lot today and I got a lot done. But that's not the point of me saying this. The point of me saying this is to ask you guys how you guys' day was. Because if you watch my videos, automatically, we're friends now. So, virtual dap up. Once again, thank you so much. Please subscribe. Please like. Please comment how your day or your week was. And I'll get back to you. And I'll see you in the next video next week. And Eric, he... We out. Boom.